This video will guide you through replacing the strap on StrongArm electric winch models TW4000 and TW4015 made by the Dutton-Lainson Company. If you own a TW9000 or TW9015, select the card above for the video that covers those models. This process varies a little bit depending on if you have a TW4000 or 4015. So follow along only when you see your winch's model number in the top left corner of the screen. On both models, your first step is to unplug your winch from any power source. Then it's time to remove its cover. Use a flathead screwdriver to loosen the slotted nut in the center of the freewheel knob. Then spin the knob off of the clutch stud with the nut inside of it. If you have a TW4000, grab a 9/16 inch socket wrench and loosen the nut holding the toggle switch in place. Then lift the switch guard off of the cover with the nut inside of it. On TW4015s, use a basic pair of pliers to pinch the strain relief bushing out of its hole in the cover. Next, use a 3/8 inch wrench to loosen and remove the four cover screws. Lift the cover completely off of the winch, using a screwdriver for help to get it started if needed. On a TW4000, you may have to push the toggle switch through its hole to get the cover off. We then recommend that you spin the freewheel knob back onto the clutch stud to prevent any parts from falling off of it. Pull the motor wires and clip off of a TW4000 base and move them out of your way behind the motor. Rotate the reel until the strap bolt and nut are accessible on the non-clutch side of your winch. Use two 9/16 inch wrenches to loosen and remove the nut. Pull your old strap from the winch until no layers are left on it. Then slip the strap bolt out of the strap's loop so you can completely remove it. Make sure the stitching on your new strap is facing down, then line up the loop in the end of the strap with the oblong shape slots in the reel. Slide the reel bolt through the slots and strap loop, and tighten the nut on its end with your 9/16 inch wrenches until it is just barely snug. Spin your winch's reel so the strap is coming off the top of it, not the bottom, and hold back on the end of it to make it as tight on the reel as you can. Also make sure that the strap is installed in flat layers like this and not bunched up against the reel side plates. Then you can spin the black knob off of the clutch stud one more time. If you own a TW4000, press the motor wire clip back onto the side of the base so it's lined up with the reel's drum hub. And make sure the black tape section of the wires is not touching the winch's reel. Stretch out the front of the cover and place it back over the base. On TW4000s, you'll have to slip the toggle switch back into its hole in the cover and pull it through with your set of pliers until it's snugly in place. Line up the notches on both the toggle switch and toggle switch guard as you place the guard over the switch. Then slightly rotate the guard until the notch on its underside lines up with the small hole in the cover. Place the switch nut over the switch, then firmly tighten it with your 9/16 inch socket wrench. Spin the black knob back onto the clutch stud one last time, then tighten the slotted nut back onto the center of it with a flathead screwdriver. If you have a TW4015, gently pull the pigtail out of the cover so little slack remains inside of it. Put the strain relief bushing back onto the cord, then use your pliers to help you squeeze the bushing back into its hole in the cover. Grab the two longer cover screws and retighten them into the clutch side of the winch. And reinstall the two shorter cover screws into the non-clutch side of the winch to finish the strap replacement process. Thanks for watching. Are there any other technical processes you'd like us to walk you through in a video? Let us know in the comments below.